When I was very little, my grandfather was disabled by a long-term paralysis. This paralysis was so extensive and debilitating that he was not unable to talk, and he was also not unable to communicate from his bed. And I was so young at that time, but today I realize how uncomfortable he must have been and how difficult it must have been for him to express his needs and to let people know that he needed help. I am from a country of Bangladesh in South Asia, but just east part of northern India. In my home country, we have many beautiful customs and great cultural values that are very important for us. One of these is family bonding. In our country, the family, typical family, is not only dad, mom, and kids. Like in America, family is very important, like us. But me and my siblings grew up a big family where my mom, my dad, my grandparents, and other extended family members all live together in a single home. Just imagine an episode of Bangladesh real world. We shared everything together, our joy, our happiness, our love. We also shared our crisis together. As a result, the care of my paralyzed grandfather fell to my family, particularly to my mom. I saw my mom firsthand to take care of him. Most of the time, my grandfather couldn't go to the restroom by himself, and my mom had to do all cleanup. After a miserable life of 1 year on bed, my grandfather passed away. On that time, I was just 3 years old. At that time, the adult diaper had not been introduced in my home country. Many technologies and ideas that have come along recently, I cannot recall all of my memory of that time, but I still remember my mom's sacrifice and hard work to take care of my grandfather. I love my mom a lot, maybe more than my life. When I had grown up a little bit and had started my journey towards college, my memory of that time made me realize the fact that incontinence is a large problem. Incontinence is lack of voluntary control of urination or bowels. And I came to understand that my mom is not alone taking care of patients like my grandfather. There is a lot of people like my mom. There's many mom like my mom who take care of the patients like my grandfather. And there's lots of nurses and caregivers, they do the same thing. 3 years ago, I met Inus Bargik, who has been a nurse for nearly 40 years at Sanford Hospital in Fargo, North Dakota. I shared the story of my mom and my grandfather with her, and she shared her experience at hospital then and now. Today, because of innovation and technology, the life of a caregiver is much easier because we now have the adult diaper. But based on her experience at the hospital, I found that there is still some problem with the availability of adult diaper. One, elderly patient, bedridden acute care patient who are in nursing home and hospital are feeling discomfort, are sometimes unable to communicate that they need their diaper changed. Two, they must depend on nurses who normally check the patients only at periodic interval. And three, the extended time of having a soiled or wet diaper can cause other problems like skin infections. Then I began to do research and found that according to the Center of Disease Control and Prevention, urinary incontinence affects at least 10 million Americans. 1.5 million people living in nursing homes and hospitals, more than half of them are incontinent. 8% to 20% of adult patients in the hospital are affected by incontinence. There are remote sensing technologies on the market right now. They can sense dryness or wetness, but they don't work for this application because one is They are too expensive. Two, most of them are not disposable because they use batteries. We need a simple, low-cost sensing solution that is disposable and flexible, that is environmentally friendly, and that doesn't hurt the patient. Together with other researchers and collaborators, I began to looking for the solution to this problem. After several prototypes, I designed a moisture sensor that is flexible, disposable, and very inexpensive, as it does not need any battery. The moisture sensor is an antenna made of inexpensive conductive trays with a chip on paper. That makes this moisture sensor very cost effective. That's why my sensor is the right choice for the individuals and the organizations like hospitals and nursing homes that need an efficient and inexpensive solution. We all are surrounded by light, and light is nothing but electromagnetic radiation within a certain portion of electromagnetic spectrum that is visible to the eye. We are also surrounded by many electromagnetic waves for different types of technologies to communicate, to control, and to surveillance. All of these technologies use different frequencies of electromagnetic waves, especially within the RF, that is radio frequency range of the electromagnetic spectrum. In my design, a passive chip is used on the antenna. Without any RF signal, the chip was dormant. But when the RF signal of a particular frequency is sent, the passive chip harvests the energy from the RF signal and acts as an active component. Then the antenna with the active chip sends an RF signal back to the receiver, and it is designed in such a way the antenna sends the RF signal to the chip and different frequency they get from the antenna. And based on the received signal, it can easily say it's dry or wet. Even we can say the percentage of dryness and wetness determined without interrupting the patient. This is how the sensor works without a battery. The benefit of this technology was immediately apparent. Now, instead of interval checking, this solution will immediately alert the caregiver that the diaper needs to be changed. Due to the paper construction, the sensor placed in the diaper will be comfortable for the patient. Since a receiver, handheld, or desktop reads the paper of the sensor wirelessly, the patient's need can be known without physically checking. The potential benefit of the busy caregivers are time savings, workload reductions, and the increase in the quality of care they can offer. And the potential benefit for the patients is increased comfort, less harassment, increased dignity, and all kind of good lifestyle they can lead. We can use this technology behind this technology we can use in different areas. For example, we can use this technology for soil sensors. In that case, the farmer can get the soil sensor from the sensors from the farmer, and we can use this for pacemaker and biomedical instruments. Those are the life savings data to the user. I wish I could offer this solution to my mom and my grandfather, as it would have been so helpful to them. That time has passed, but there are millions of others around the world who can get benefit from this technology. My heart goes out to them, and I am excited to be able to offer this solution to them. I wish I could help science advance. If I can do that, I am all for it. But if I want to ensure the comfort for all the people like my grandfather. Thank you.